The current energy system has been developed for the accommodation of conventional electricity generation. But now we need to change this system. We need to adapt it and make it suitable for more renewable energy sources in order to facilitate the energy transition. What impacts will a large amount of renewable energy sources have on the energy system? And how can we adapt it to accommodate the energy transition? Today's objective is to discuss the impact of introducing a large amount of renewable energy sources into the system. In this video, we will focus on the electricity networks. Let's start with wind energy. For wind turbines to operate efficiently, we need, of course, wind. It makes sense to locate the wind turbines in the areas with the most wind available. For Europe, these are indicated by the dark red areas on this map, plotting wind speeds up to 10 meters per second. The most suitable areas are in the coastal regions of Europe, especially the North Sea and the ocean in the northwest. The same holds for sun energy. In order to generate electricity efficiently with solar panels, you need to have a high level of irradiation. And the southern parts of Europe have more irradiation than the northern parts. So it makes sense to generate solar electricity in southern Europe. The cost per kilowatt hour produced are less in Spain and Italy than in northern Europe. This is solely related to the fact that the cost of both wind and solar installations is mostly capex, and the operational costs are fairly low. So the number of operating hours immediately impacts the efficiency of the generation and the cost per kilowatt hour of electricity produced. Electricity consumption, however, happens where people live, in cities spread all over the continent. As the generation of renewable energy is highly geographically specific, either in the windy northwest or the sunny southern half of Europe, we need to bring electricity from this location to the consumer. And to do this, we need long-distance transport. Long-distance transport can also help to overcome seasonal fluctuations in renewable energy sources. In the winter, when there is less sun, it may be necessary to transport electricity from locations further away, perhaps as far as Africa, to ensure that electricity demand can be met. So as the amount of renewable energy in the energy mix increases, our energy system will become increasingly reliant on long-distance transport. This increasing reliance on electricity transport will have impacts on the transmission and distribution network. The current electricity network is made up of a kind of chain between generation and consumption. Consumers are connected to the distribution grid, which is fed by the transmission grid. The transmission grid is in turn being fed by the generators. The large-scale renewable power generation will be linked to specific geographic regions, for instance, Northwest Europe for wind and Southern Europe for solar power. If this is going to develop further, we will need a huge amount of transport all over Europe and a huge amount of new transmission links to facilitate this development. For the large wind farms in Northwest Europe, they will feed electricity into the high voltage grid. So there must be additional transport capacity at shorelines. In addition, smaller scale renewable generation, such as solar parks and onshore wind turbines, typically feed into the distribution grid. This can be a problem in sunny areas with cheap land, if many solar parks are built. All solar farms will produce power at the same time, and so can cause congestion in the distribution grid in those specific locations. This is a particular problem right now in parts of the Netherlands. So additional distribution capacity must be built to accommodate this. At the same time, consumers are starting to generate electricity themselves, mostly through rooftop solar. So one effect of the energy transition is that there will be more local renewable generation. Consumers that generate electricity are also called prosumers. For prosumer buildings, two-way operation of the electricity network is needed. This will allow power to be injected in the grid during the day, when the sun produces electricity, and withdrawal of power from the grid at night. As the grid has previously been designed for one-way power flows, this must be considered in the future. These are just a few of the impacts that a large amount of renewable energy sources can have on the electricity system, and some of the solutions that will be needed to solve it. However, there are many more that have not been touched on here, such as the impact on electricity markets and electricity prices, and on security of supply. To which extent will these impacts be relevant for the energy transition?